Hello, everybody.
I'm Chris, Castle Paranormal.
What we're going to do is we're going to try to communicate with Angelo's mom. And we have a flashlight on the table over here. Let's take a seat, Ange. The flashlight is right over here. We have an EMF right here. We're going to turn it on. Okay, we're going to place it over here. We have a reading of zero right now. Okay, so there's no activity happening right now. With the EMF, we're going to place that right here.
Comes in now, we're going to invite him in. Only good spirits allowed only. And one word particularly, here we go. That's a very good spirit.
Fortune tellers, soothsayers, witches, mind readers, mystics, gypsies. A seemingly endless list of names for a profession that few embrace and many refuse to understand. To this end, society has not accepted psychics with open arms. Many assume psychics can only be found behind a crystal ball or on the other end of a telephone line, when in fact, they can be found amongst us in everyday life. Their jobs being not that different from our own.
I have been doing this since I'm about 8.
Wow.
And I am just about 50 now. And my father does it, my sister does it, my two aunts do it, my great grandmother did it. What I do is I would consider myself a paranormal investigator and a medium. I cannot read any people that are living, but I can tell you who has passed if they want to give you a message. But the difference between myself and some of the other mediums is I don't go through a series of 30 to 40 names. I will just sit there and I'll tell you what I see. It's a movie that plays in my head. And the people will give me hand gestures and tell me this and tell me that. I did readings. If you go onto my website, mm-hmm. You'll see the readings on my guest book. I told the people full contents of their home down in Florida, mm-hmm. And that what their mother was doing, with pointing to the wind chimes, and she was standing right near the wind chimes. I did one recently. The gentleman dared me at my other job. Give me a reading. So I said, is it an uncle standing right by you? And I described his uncle to a T.
Wow.
And he was like, yeah, that's what he said. And then he said, and then I told him how he works and that he's tired and he works a lot, you know. And he goes, yeah, you described even his work ethic. You described that. How do you do that? The truth is, I have not a clue.
It just comes out of nowhere, like you just see.
That I had ever since I was a child. I'll give you just another story. I had a friend of mine who passed. His name is John. And I kept on having dreams about him for about 3 years. Kept on having dreams. Finally, I found a sister on Facebook. And I said, listen, I need to speak to John. You're going to give me his number. He was my childhood friend. And we reunited once, and then we lost each other again. And he kept on knocking on the back of a school bus door and waving to me, knocking on the back. Kept on bugging me, so finally I got a hold of her, and she said, oh, I'm sorry, he passed away. Yeah, he died, and I guess it was his way of saying, hey, you know, here I am.
Yeah.
And his mother was a school bus driver, by the way.
Huh.
She used to drive one of those little yellow school buses, and it used to sit in front of the house.
When someone asks you to read them and stuff, what do? You just walk up to them and start reading, or do you have, like, a trance you go into? Do you have some type of...
I'm
confused right now.
Okay. Like, if you said, oh, you know, can you read me? I do not read on command.
Yeah, that's kind of what I mean. Like, when someone
says... If somebody has something to say, if somebody has something that they want to convey to you, mm-hmm. then they come to me. Like a relative of yours that has passed. Now, if you wanted to know a relative of yours that has just passed, like a grandmother, you know, I can see like a grandmother that's standing beside you then. Okay? And she would put her hand on your shoulder.
Oh.
You know, and do I go through a trance? No. Do I look at you sometimes? No. Do I look up in the air so I can watch the movie? Yes. Now, you're young. I wouldn't think that your grandmother would have passed already. But I mean,
she was older. She was in her 80s, I think.
80s. Yeah. Mm. But a young 80s? Or?
Actually, she was 90, I think, when she passed away. She's older, and my parents are older, and my grandparents are older.
Did she have lung problems?
No.
Was she a young 90s? Like a young 90s, or was she an old 90s?
No, she was a young 90s.
Yeah. Because she seems young now. Like she seems like she has her faculties.
Yeah, that's...
Like
sounds
she's
right.
With it, you know?
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool. Let's hope I'm like that. You can actually do an investigation anywhere and bring these people in that you want to communicate with, like your grandmother, for instance. Mm-hmm. If you would like to communicate with your grandmother and ask her some questions, we can try to bring her eventually next time.
Yeah, I don't know about that.
Here and let her answer the questions through the flashlight, through the EVP, and through the EMFs.
They're just yes or no questions. That's
yeah, and if
we ask the question, if they say yes,
you'll be able to see. You'll be able to see activity with our night vision equipment. And it's really pretty cool stuff.
...meters, or the flashlight for us. If you want to say hello to Mike.
Wow, it's getting really cold.
Are you making it cold in here for them? To show them that you're near him?
There you go.
Thank you.
No confirmation.
Yeah, very much so. Okay, thank you. Turn off the flashlight for us. Pull away.
Yeah,
thank you.
Get that.
Put this into your documentary. Is there anything else that you want to say to him? Okay, turn it off.
That's big. That's a lot of energy right here.
Yeah, pretty wide.
So, do you know that he visits you?
Are you there when... Do you see him when he visits you? Okay.
It's a pretty nice light, so that's definitely yes.
We're going to go now. It was very nice to meet you. Very nice to talk to you. Mike says he loves you, and he'll go and visit you, knowing that you watch him now.
What the fuck?
Oh, did you do that?
No, I think the battery just died or something.
By itself?
Was the battery charged?
I don't know.
One thing that you need to learn is that when spirits are around,
they will drain
your battery.
Yeah. Oh,
you
have backup.
I do have a backup.
That was her? That was her?
All right.
That's where she was getting the energy from.
Okay, pull away from the flashlight. Thank you. Mike, why don't you guys exit us out? Say this is, you know, say your names and this Castle Paranormal. Yeah.
I'm Amanda, and this is Mike, and this is Castle Paranormal.
And Mike is freaked out because his grandmother happened to come through to him tonight.
So, what's my take on all this? I think your future is whatever you make it. Only you can determine your future. If you want to listen to somebody's advice, then go ahead and take it. But you shouldn't let someone else's advice get in your way. All of them are pretty convincing, I gotta admit. But I still believe that your fate is up to you and only you. But am I a believer in what these people say and can do? Goddamn right I am. We'll be right back.
dressed in black. Remember that, just in case we ever face to face and make contact. The title held by me, MIB, means what you think you saw, you did not see. So don't blink, be what was dead is now gone. Black suit with the black ray bands on, walk a shadow, move the silence.